Welcome to Mailbag Monday, holiday edition. And to celebrate, I'm going to open another local beer to start with. Brewed in a small town of Manitoba called Nipawa, Manitoba. These guys actually, you've heard of an estate winery. That's where they grow all the ingredients and brew all on the same property. Well, that's exactly what these guys have done, only for beer. They're like a multi-generation farm. They've been growing barley forever. So they decided to open a brewery. And they're growing their own barley and their own hops and brewing all right on the family farm, which I think is pretty cool. This is one of theirs that I haven't tried before. It's called a Robbie Scotch Ale. Their main beer, the one that they've made since the beginning, is a lager that's relatively hoppy and a bit more hoppy than I'm a fan of. This one, being a Scotch Ale, I'm hoping, is a lot more to my preference. Not as thick a head as I was expecting. Let's see what we got here. It's lighter than most Scotch Ales that I've tried. It's bit of caramel, bit of kind of roasted malt, but quite light. That's interesting. I think I get used to that. Okay, now that that's open, let's see what all this Chinese stuff is here. Okay, the first thing, they're actually pretending to tell me what's in here. They're saying there's 10 pieces of 3-amp lithium ion 18650 3.7 battery charger protection board. Quantity 1 of 10 pieces and 2.5 amp quantity 1. Okay. That's pretty specific. Let's see if it's really what's in there. Oh. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 1. Okay. So the 10 of them, it says, are 3 amp, and the single one is 2.5 amp. That's interesting. So it looks like they're designed, yeah, these guys are designed to stack right on top of an 18650 cell. And what do we got for pads? So there's a B plus, B minus, P minus, P plus there. And this would be a lot easier for you to see if I zoomed in a little bit. And on this one, B minus, P plus. So that must be B plus on the back, which means they do, in fact, sit right like that. Oh, look at that. Isn't that cute? So that just clamps right to there, presumably with some heat shrink or something to hold it. Maybe some, I don't know how I'd solder that. Maybe just friction. And then B minus, you run something around to the minus side. Now those guys, component-wise, where's my magnifier here? That will be a lot easier. There we go. 8205A. And hello. TW01K smudge KM, I think. Okay, that seems pretty similar to where is it? To these little guys that we looked at last week. Oh, slightly different. Probably just a different MOSFET package. Yeah, I'll take a look at them on the listing, I guess. Obviously, they came from the same seller. I think the reason that I ordered these, and probably these too, is I remember a couple months ago seeing a video from Andreas, the guy with the Swiss accent, who was looking at these guys too. So I decided to give them a shot myself. 10 pieces, 1 series 3 amp lithium-ion lithium, 3.7 18650 battery charger, BMS protection PCB board. From Best for Sale, $4.66 for the 10 of them, so 46 cents each. Let's see if it says anything about them down below here. 1 amp to 3 amps, overcharge detection at 4.27. Oh, come back here. Overcharge 4.27 volts plus or minus 0.025, and over discharge detection 2.5 plus or minus 0.1. Anything else to say? Oh yeah, there's a whole set of specs here. Overcharge kicks in between 150 and 500 milliseconds. Overcurrent between 5 and 15 milliseconds. So it claims to be a 3-amp device, and it overcurrent detection happens at 4.5 plus or minus a half. Automatic recovery, short circuit protection. Well, that's kind of interesting. There we go. B plus B minus for battery positive. P plus and P minus for battery output. So that's what goes to the rest of your circuit. And also from Best for Sale, 2.5 amp, 1 series lithium ion, lithium, etc. All the same information. This one I won at auction. I was the third bidder. I paid 28 cents for one of these. What were the other ones? About 46 cents after, once you divided them up. So that's a pretty good deal. This one's a little bit smaller around, as you saw, and it is 2.5 amps. And I'm going to guess the rest of the specs down here are pretty similar. Overcharge 4.25, over discharge 2.45. Well, that's a little bit different. Upper limit continuous 2 amps, over current 2.5. I see components DW01 and 8205A. And the instructions are the same. Yeah, B plus B minus for the battery, P plus P minus to the circuit. Yeah, I think I get used to that. It's not exactly the sort that I always like, but I can get used to that. What do we have here? Speaker module. One time speaker module and one time speaker module. So basically, two speaker modules. Surprise, surprise, surprise. Okay, I know I've got some of these, but I ordered more. These are just single pole momentary switches. Looks like 10 black and 10 red with mounting hardware and whatnot. Planning on using those for local control panels on my railroad, for controlling the servos for the turnouts. Kind of like that prototype that I just slapped together quickly. And that one controls the Arduino, which controls the servo that controls those turnout points. 5 or 10 pieces PBS 110 on off push button black or red or blue mini lockless momentary switches. So from LS110 1983, $2.15 for the 10 black ones, $2.09 inexplicably for the red ones. I should have got more of the red ones and just painted them black. Next up, we have description of contents, something in Chinese. Yeah, well, they might be lying. We'll never know. A set of test probes. Okay. Oh, those are kind of flexible. So here, over here is some actual Fluke one, so from the actual Fluke meter. Nice flexible wire. These ones are not as flexible. They're still, more flexible than, and a little bit thicker too than the ones that came with this ultra cheap meter. Little dust caps on them. Will they plug into my Fluke meter? Hang on here. Yes, they will. Okay. Will they plug into Mr. Cheapy meter? Not really. Too much installation for this little cheap guy to deal with. Oh well, that'd be good for the 1 meter anyway. Alright, and what's going on at this end? Oh, little condoms on that end too. Those are nice sharp, and they've got a little ridge there so you can get onto a lead without skating off, much like the high quality Fluke ones have. Oh, even these cheap ones have that. Okay, where's my little pocket meter? It doesn't, it's just straight probes. But I can't use those with it because those are permanently attached. Still. Oops. Put the dust cap on the wrong one. They look a lot like the Fluke probes. If you, go way back and squint a little bit. They claim to be category 2. So I'm not going to be using them for silly high voltage, although they say that they're good for 10 amps and 1,000 volts max. Interesting. Multimeter, universal multimeter, digital test lead, probe, wire, pen, cable, KB. Whatever KB means. From HZYP01, HKZYP01_0. Okay, $2.79. For what they felt like, that's definitely a good price. Free shipping from Hong Kong. What does it say? Black and gray, red and gray, yes. Silicone, maybe. 34 inches cable, 41 inches overall. Like it said embossed on it, 1,000 volt 10 amp, but I don't believe it, and I'm not going to use them that high. Yada yada yada. That's everything about those. Okay, next. Description of contents module. That's a good mystery. What do we got? It may be a kit of some sort. It says DIY, it says HV1. What do we got in here? We have possibly a transformer, I guess. Terminal lugs, push button, tie wrap, screw, nut, diode. Anything magic about that diode? 1N5819. 470 microfarad, 16 volt capacitor, a 1 watt resistor, I guess. And some manner of transistory type thing. And then a circuit board, which says EQ kit on that end. It even says HV1 on this side. Okay. Okay, so that, that's the, okay. So this power to 220 power device goes on there. And it's just got some vias to carry the heat through onto that plane on the back. There's a fair bit of ground plane around this area which is where the capacitor is. That's interesting. I'm going to have to go digging through the listing to figure out what this thing is.
DIY Kits HV-1 High Voltage Igniter Kit. Arc Ignition Generator Suite DC 3 to 5 volts, 3 amps. 3 amp input. Wow. From Chip World. Bought a bunch of stuff from them in the past. I got this as an auction item for $2.29 Canadian. After 14 long bids. Well, that's cool. What do we got to say for ourselves down here? Arc generator through the 3 to 5 volt power supply produces a short arc. Input 3 to 5 volts. It oscillates at 20 kilohertz, which is how it creates its high voltage. It takes the 3 to 5 volts in, oscillates that, punches that using the big transistor on there and the capacitor and resistor as timing elements. Then the output of that goes through the high ratio transformer and comes out the other side as some sort of high voltage, which it hasn't really told me what the voltage is going to be. What do we say about the transformer? Just the physical dimensions. Okay. No real instructions, just complete the installation by the silk screen. Well, there's no risk at all for that. So that's all that there. Wonder how I'm going to measure the output voltage of this. Or if I even want to try. Well, that should be a fun kit to put together. Although maybe I'll abstain from beer that day. Just 'cause. Or maybe I need more so I don't feel it. Oh, we'll see.
And one more. One times acrylic shell, 3 times diode. That's a fairly sizable thing. Nothing left in there. Oh, 3 LED assortments. Okay. Let's get that packing foam out of the way. So they look like, they're 3 of the same pack. Okay. So it looks like I'm stocking up on LEDs. Also looks like I probably got a really good deal on them. What have we got for colors here? Obviously blue. Definitely obviously blue. Okay. Hope you can see what that is because my old colorblind eyes can't tell you. That one looks different, I think. Yeah, that one looks pretty red to me. Which means that's probably green. I wonder what these water clear ones are. Kind of a bluish white. Okay. Is there any? Let's pick another random one just to see if these are something else. Okay.
300 pieces, 20 milliamp F5 5 millimeter, 5 colors, ultra bright LED diode. Yes, most LEDs are in fact diodes. So, 5 colors. To my eye, they're a lot easier to distinguish here. Red, green, yellow, white, and blue. But let's see what it says down here. Red, yellow, blue, green, and white. Yes, 300 LEDs. And if you really care about the nanometers, there you go. It's all there. White color temperature is 8,000, which is quite blue, at least to my eyes. Well, you saw them earlier, so you can tell me. Well, there we go. Look at that. What a nice display. Anyway, I got these ones, as you can see, off Banggood.
Okay, and what is this kit? Looks like some plexiglass or acrylic or something, and some nuts and bolts. So this is clearly a case for something. Case for an Arduino, maybe? See if this gives us any... Oh! It's a case for Amiga. Okay, I've got one of those. Which makes perfect sense, because why would I have ordered it if I didn't have one? Well... Where are we here? There we go, Amiga. Okay. So that's got all the necessary. There's Echo that way. Oh, yes, that goes that way. Okay, so it's not a perfect fit. That's pretty close, but it's not quite a perfect fit for this one. Then again, this is a generic Mega clone. This isn't an official one. So I guess I shouldn't be too surprised that it's not an absolutely perfect fit. Okay, how does this go together? Bunch of screws, tear off the protective film, install board 2, the bottom, onto board 1, that end, which is that piece. Install the demo board to board 1 with 4 pieces of M2 times 10 millimeter screws. Fix the parts with transparent washers, then put on 3, 4, and 5. Okay. I'll just quickly mock this up. Mock. That goes on that side. And that goes kind of like that. And then the screws all sort of hold it together. Well, that should be fun to throw together one day. And put this guy into it. I'll probably have to do a little bit of filing and adjusting, but that's okay. Also from Banggood, transparent acrylic shell box for Arduino Mega 2560 R3 module board. $3.89. And that looks an awful lot like it. What does it have to say for itself? Material, a level acrylic for the Mega 2560 R3 development board only. Due to different batch, some packages come with it, the copper column, but does not affect use. Oh, okay. Some of them have standoff, some of them don't. Mine doesn't. It's just got screws and nuts. But that's okay. It doesn't affect use. They assured me of that. And that's today's Mailbag Monday haul. Festive edition, I guess. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. I wouldn't keep doing this if you guys didn't actually like them, and at least a few of you have told me that you do. I'm probably going to do one more of these weekly Mailbag Mondays just to round out the year. And then I'm thinking let's discuss it down below. I'm thinking I might keep the mailbags on Monday so they don't interrupt the regular Friday videos, but I won't do them every week, maybe every second or every third week, because I don't want to run out of stuff or be opening, completely lame and useless things. If I get something that I've opened 3 or 4 times before, when I'm opening it, I'll just not bother to edit it in. So there's no reason to discover the same thing over and over again. That's just pointless and probably boring for you guys. But I don't know. Discuss it amongst yourselves down below in the comments. Other than that, thanks for watching. Talk to you later.